Hello friends, welcome back to MacDay, and in this video we will be discussing about Bootstrap grids. This might be quite confusing for beginners, so the best way to learn or understand it is to carry out some practical examples. So this video is just about that. I will be showing some examples of using various kinds of grids and how to implement it properly so that you can create any kind of a layout, responsive layout using Bootstrap 4. So let's get started. So first of all, you will have to go to this website called getbootstrap.com, and you can click the download button here on the home page, which besides the get started button, and this will redirect you to this downloads page. And on this page there are two parts. One is the download source and other is the download the compiled version of CSS and JS Bootstrap. So you will have to click this download button, and once the Bootstrap is downloaded, you just unzip the Bootstrap file, and you will find two folders inside this. One is for the CSS and the other is for the JavaScript files. So you just need to copy these two folders and create a new project folder. Here I will name it Bootstrap Grid and just paste the two folders inside this. So let's open the CSS folder, and you will find various CSS files. We will be using only this file bootstrap.min.css, and in JS we'll be using bootstrap.min.js. Min stands for the minified version or the compressed version, so we will be using those for this project. So in this video I will be explaining you about Bootstrap grids and how grids work. So this will be a rather slow video. If you feel it's too slow, you can speed it up using the YouTube speed option on the bottom right corner. I will be opening these files. First I will open the folder, project folder here, so that you can see all the files in the left panel in Sublime Text. So here you can see all the files. So first of all, let me save a home page called index.html. And I will create another file for our style sheet, which will be overriding the Bootstrap style sheet. So let's name it style.css and save it in CSS folder. Now let me type the structure of the HTML file and give a title name as Bootstrap Grid. Now before we begin, we need to link some of the files. So first of all, we will require to link these files. Here in the get started documentation page, you will find the link to a Bootstrap JavaScript file as well as CSS file. So as we have downloaded the file, we don't need to use that CDN. Instead, you can just link to the downloaded version. Just give the path as CSS and bootstrap.min.css. Now once the style sheet is linked, you need to link our own style sheet, that is style.css. And after that you need to link the JavaScript files. So I will just use the script tag and give source as JavaScript JS slash bootstrap.min.js. Now remember that bootstrap.min.js requires two other files. One is a jQuery file and another is a popper.min.js file. I will show you here in the documentation. You will find this just below these two links. So here, if you are using a compiled JavaScript, you will need jQuery and popper. So the easiest way to include these files is to just copy it and paste it in the browser and just right click on a blank space. I am using Chrome, So just right click and save as, and save to the project folder's JS folder. And likewise also save the popper.min.js file. Just copy the URL and paste it in the address bar. Click on the blank space and save the file in the project JS folder. So we have all the files required for a Bootstrap project. I will not be using anything from the JS thing in this project because I am going to just explain you about the grid layout. But this is how you can include the Bootstrap files for any project. So I will just include the jQuery file. Now remember the sequence while including these files. First you need to link the style sheet. Then you need to link the jQuery file and then the popper.min.js and lastly the bootstrap.min.js. This order of linking should be maintained for all the projects. So we are done with the linking. Now before we go into the coding part, we will just check whether everything is linked well, that our Bootstrap is working. So for the purpose of that, I will just create a container here, or instead of container, I will just type a h1 tag. Now let's check it in the browser. Now you can see that this is a font which is used in Bootstrap. So our Bootstrap installation is working fine. I will just include this in the container. Class division. So let's check it now. So it includes some space on the left, so it's inside the fixed container. So let's delete this portion and let's start with the grid layout. So this grid will explain everything. Actually this is the Bootstrap 4 grid, or this is how the columns are divided in grids. So this is the class name which is used, the format of the class name which is used. That is, first we have the letters COL, which stands for column, and then we have a hyphen and two letters which define the device screen size. It can be extra small, a small, medium device, or large or extra large. So it can be 5 devices in total. I will explain to this later. And the last numerical value, this is what we are going to see now. So this is the part of the total 12 width column. So this means 1 by 12, for example. So this column is just one part out of the 12 parts. So this row is total 12 parts long. So this is just one part out of the 12 part. Likewise, this is just the two parts out of the 12 parts. The total length of, or the width of the row is 12 parts. So that's how Bootstrap works. So here you can see that we have 12 blocks in the first row, whereas in the second row we have only the 6 parts. That's because its width is 2. So this takes the width of 2 columns. So that's why we have mentioned 2 here. So the total columns which can fit into this row is only 6, because 6 into 2 is 12. Likewise here, each of the blocks here is 3 grids long. So that's why only 4 blocks can fit in here, because 4 into 3 is 12. So that's how a grid system works in Bootstrap 4. You just need to divide it into parts, assuming that the total width is 12 grids long. So this is 3 grids, this is 3 grids, and likewise. So we have 4 columns of 3 grids each, and that tallies up to 12. So in this case we have the same scenario here, but here we are taking the width of 6 grids. So this is equivalent to this grid plus this grid. So that's why this grid occupies the total width of both these grids. If you add up these grid, the total will always be 12. So here you can see that 3 plus 6 is 9, 9 plus 3 is 12. Likewise, here it's the same thing. And here also you can see that 8 plus 4 is 12. And here it's divided into two parts of 6 each. And here you can see that it's 2 on the left and 2 on the right and 8 in the middle. So it adds up to 12 columns. So this is how we can divide divisions or blocks. And lastly, here you can see that this is a full length column and it has a width of 12 grids. So this is how the Bootstrap grid system works. Hope you have understood about how to divide a grid into several parts. Now we will be focusing on what this XX stands for. So these are the five screen sizes. First is extra small, which is denoted by XS, two letters, and the second one is small. Small is for screen sizes greater than 576 pixels. So this is the extra small one, which is less than 576 pixels, and small is greater than 576 pixels, and medium is greater than 768 pixels, and large is for screen sizes which are greater than 992 pixels, which is denoted by LG. And the last one, which is denoted by XL, stands for extra large, and it's for screen sizes greater than 1200 pixels. So I will just show you an example so that you can understand this in a practical way. So let's code, start coding, and I will just show an example for small devices. So here I have mentioned the text first inside a division block. And I have given the class name as COLSM4, which stands for small devices, and I have used a grid width of 4. So this should divide the row into 3 columns. Now let's see in the browser. Here you can see that it's already divided into 3 columns. You can't see the exact width of the block. So let's go ahead and create some colors and backgrounds for these divisions. So let's first create some classes to define our background colors. So I will just copy and paste this. So let's define it as gray 1, gray 2 and gray 3, and I will use different shades of gray. Now let's add these classes to the HTML file. So we will add one more class here, gray 1, gray 2 and gray 3, so that we can see the exact width of these divisions. Now you can see the exact width, that it's divided into equal 3 parts. That's because each one of these is using 4 grids. So 4 into 3 is 12, as I had shown you previously. So if I reduce the window size, you can see that it collapses at a certain point here. So this is where it collapses because I have used SM4. SM4, if you remember, stands for screen sizes greater than 576 pixels. So let me change this and change it to medium devices, which is denoted by MD. And now let's go back to the browser and check whether it gets. Now here you can see that it's not getting divided into 3 columns right here, but it will get divided into 3 columns at a larger screen size. Now you can see that it's happening here. So these points are called breakpoints. That's where the divisions gets changed into a different column layout. So these are called breakpoints in responsive web design. Now you can see, as soon as I changed it to large device, it takes some more screen size to get divided into 3 columns. So you can see how it's working here. Now if I use Excel for extra large, it will only get divided into three parts when the screen size is more than 1200 pixels. So here you see it that it gets divided when it's more than 1200 pixels long. Now in this example we have used similar width for all the columns. We can change the width also, and we can include one more class here. For example, here I am defining a class name as column SM6, which is for small devices. So in the case of small devices, I am using 6 plus 6, that is 12, and one more column for 12. So what will happen is this row will get divided into two rows. First row will be of 6 plus 6, that is 12 width, 12 grids long, and the second row is already 12 widths long. And this will apply only for small devices, whereas for the Excel extra large device, it will be three column layout. Let's see by refreshing. Now, when it gets into the small devices width, here you can see that it's taking the first rows. First column is 6 grids long, and the second is 6 grids long, so it's 12 in total, and the third is 12 grids long. Now this applies only to small device. Now when I increase the width of this, it will change at the Excel breakpoint, that is extra large breakpoint, into a three column layout. Now this happens because when we use SM, that is small device, it applies also to the medium device as well as large device. So it's upward compatible. You can just remember it that way. Now when I'm just changing the small device width to 12 so that it's a full width layout, and I will be giving some more colors here so that you can better understand this grid layout in this single video. So I will just name it first to sixth and add some more classes here to define three more colors. The purpose of this video is to make you understand about how to use grids. So I'm taking this video very slowly so that everybody get used to this Bootstrap 4 grid layout system. So now let's check this out in the browser, and you will see that we have all the six columns, and it breaks at a certain point of 1200 pixels because we have used Excel 4 for extra large devices. Now we will add some more classes here. Now this column dash 12 stands for extra small because we don't need to use XS here. So you can just directly type in column dash 12, which is for small device, extra small device, and SM is for small device. Now later on here, we will just change the values for the small devices to 6 so that two columns fit in a row. And for the medium device, we will give a value of 4. I will just copy and paste this. So here you can see that I am manipulating the way the columns are arranged in each of the screen sizes. So here I need to just change the screen description to large. So for medium devices, I am using a grid width of 4, whereas for the large devices, I am using a grid width of 3. So in case of very small device, that is extra small device, it will take a full width column, whereas in case of small device, it will take a half width column. That is, two blocks will fit in a row in case of small device. In case of medium device, three columns will fit in, and in case of large device, four columns, and in case of extra large device, all the columns will fit in a single row because I am using a width of only two. So hopefully you just pause this video, copy the code, or just retype the code and just check it in your browser, and you will understand how it works. Now here you can see that this is for the extra small device, and here it changes to small device, and I have taken a value of 6, so it divides the row into two parts. And as I have used a total of, here you can see the medium devices, and now let's go to the large device where it will fit in four blocks in a row. So here it changes into four blocks. As we have only total 6 divisions, the last two is blank here. I will just adjust the window size so that you can see the code as well as the browser in a single window. So now here you can see that large devices we have divided into three grids, so only four blocks will fit in a row, and the last two is the fifth and the sixth one. So the seventh and eighth, we don't have the seventh and eighth division, that's why it's showing it as blank. And in case of extra large devices, all the columns will fit in a single row as we are using a grid width of 2. So 6 into 2 is 12, so that's why it gets adjusted. Now we can manipulate this width for each of the screen size. That's the beauty of Bootstrap 4. Now here in this case, we will increase the width of the 5th and 6th column. So for that, we should first understand the screen size. Here it's taking the screen size for large devices, so only for the large devices we will be changing the values for the 5th and 6th division. So here instead of 3, I will change this to 6, and for the 6th division also I will change from 3 to 6. And now let's refresh, and here you can see that the column gets adjusted to the entire width, and everything else is perfect. So that's how this grid system works in Bootstrap. Here you can see that it's a two column layout. Now if I change the values for the first and the last division from 6 to 12, it will break into a four rows, because the first row will take 12 instead of 3 rows. Here it will be 4 rows, because the first will take the full 12 grids, and the last will also take the 12 grids, whereas for other screen sizes nothing will change. So similarly you can manipulate all the screen sizes. So hopefully you have got a better understanding about how grid system works in Bootstrap. Now let's move ahead and do some ordering, or change some order for our grids. And the beauty of Bootstrap is that it can be done for a particular screen size. For example, here you can see everything is arranged in a serial order. Now here for the small devices I will be changing the order. So here you see the fifth one and the fourth block. I will be changing the fifth to fourth and the fourth to fifth. To do that, you just need to add one more class. So let's change it here. and let's type here order SM, not small, it should be SM, order hyphen SM, and the value should be 4, because it's, we want this to be fourth in the total divisions, so I will change the fourth value to fifth. So this is the order value, so we have total 6 divisions, and I will also change the value for the last one, that is the sixth column. We don't need to change the order for the first three, because it will remain the same. So now let's go ahead and refresh the page, and you will notice that the fourth and fifth will interchange. Now as soon as I refreshed, you will see that the fifth and the fourth columns have interchanged its position. So this is how order works in Bootstrap, and this is very useful because sometimes you need to change the location. Here you will notice that for higher devices it might get disturbed, the layout might get disturbed. So the reason it gets disturbed is because it changes the order for all the other screen sizes also, that is the higher screen sizes. So we need to define the order for the higher screen sizes. In short, we need to reset the order. So instead of 5 here, the order is 5, but we need to give the order of 4th here, because we don't want to disturb this for other screen sizes. So here it might be a bit confusing, but you can watch this video once more if you don't understand it. The thing is, while we change the order for the small device, the order gets changed for the medium, large and extra large devices. So to keep the order, you just need to type in order MD and the real order, that is the fourth order, because we don't want these to change to fifth. We only want to change the order for the small device. So for the rest of the screen sizes higher than the small, we are mentioning order as 4 here. Here you can see that we have mentioned order 4. I will just copy and paste it here and change the value to 5, because we need to maintain the order as 5th. This will be 4 only. So I will just undo it. So this is how it works. For the last one, we don't need to mention the order, as it's default 6th. Now the last, so we don't need to add here anything. So now let's save it and check it in the browser. Here you can see that the order is well maintained, whereas only for the small devices the order will get changed. Now here it is the medium device. Now here for the small devices you can see that the order is changed for the fifth and fourth division. So I hope you understood about how to change orders in Bootstrap. Now let's move ahead and create some more divisions here. I will just use a horizontal rule break here and add one more row. And here I am just using col, C-O-L, that is a column, and adding a color. Now this has something to do with flexbox. If you don't know about flexbox, I would recommend you to go and watch my videos about flexbox. Now here I have just used a class name called col for column, and see what happens. Now here on the bottom you will see that we have 3 columns, and no matter how small you make the window, it will always fit in, so it's not getting wrapped to a second row. So sometimes you might need to do this. So this is the way to do it. You just need to use the class name col. Now suppose I want I will just add a few more blocks here so that you can better understand it. So I will just add three more divisions here. And I will just change the class name to 4, 5 and 6. Now we have 6 divisions here. Now let's check it in the browser what happens. Now here in the second row here at the bottom, you will see that it's trying to get fit, but when it comes to very small devices, the last block has collapsed. This happens when it's very too short to fit into. The way to divide these columns into separate rows is that you can include a class name as w-100. That means width 100%. So once you do that, you can see that it's getting divided into two parts. So now if you, no matter whatever the screen size, it will get fit into three columns. Now if you want to divide it into three rows, you can just use it this way. Now I will just show you by refreshing. Now you can see that it's divided into two columns. So it's pretty simple to understand. So this is all about using the column class parameter in Bootstrap. Now let's move ahead to some more things which are useful and which has something to do with Flexbox. So you will not find this kind of a tutorial anywhere else on YouTube. I am very sure about that because I myself searched for it. So I will just include one more row here, and here I will be using a class name of call again, and I will just use only two divisions, and I will be adding one more class here which we will be defining here in our CSS file. I will just name it tall box and give a height here of say 400 pixels. Now this is just to show you what happens when you use a fixed height for our columns. So I will just use a background color here so that you can identify the column in a better way. I will use a gray shade again. So now let's check this in the browser. I will just define the colors because I forgot to add the colors here. So let's check it in the browser now. Here you can see that the height of the column has increased because we had used another class, but still it's getting divided into two columns of full width because we have used the class call along with the color class. So I will just show you in a better way. So now let me just change the height so that you can better understand it. Now you can see that the color used is the one for the columns, inside columns, and the tall box color is not showing up because the background is not shown here because it's taking the full width and height, because we have mentioned a height for our tall box class. Now if I change the value here to 5 each, it will take the width of 5 grids each, and it will leave the space of 2 grids on the right blank. So now it's showing the background of the tall box, which is a dark blackish color on the right side. So let's now add some more classes which are actually flexbox classes which are used in Bootstrap. So first of all, let me just adjust the windows properly so that you can see what's happening with regard to the code as well as what's happening on the browser. So this is the code which we are working on right now, and this is the browser window. So now let us add some classes here to manipulate how these blocks look on the screen. I will just add align items start and see what happens now. I will just refresh it, and you will notice that the height of the columns have changed to take only the height of the text inside it. So if I change this start to end, you will notice that these blocks move to the bottom of this parent block, which is the tall box division. Now if I use center, it will be placed in the center vertically. These are the flexbox CSS which are used in Bootstrap. Now again, you can also use some more classes. Here you can see that as soon as I remove the class, it gets adjusted as it was earlier. Now I will just use a class name as justify content end, which would place these two blocks to the right hand side, or it aligns to the right side. So if I use center, it will horizontally center these blocks. So now it's centered horizontally. Further, you can also put in a space in between by using justify content between, and that will align these blocks on both these sides. So the gap will be in the between of these divisions. This is very much useful, and you can also use around to place gaps between all around the blocks. That is, you will get space, some space on the left as well as in on the right as well as on the center. And if you use align item center along with justify content around, you will notice that it gets placed in the center of this parent block or division. Now this is a very useful feature because you will need this several times while designing a web layout, because there will be several of the small blocks, and inside these blocks you will be placing some more content which you need to be aligned horizontally as well as vertically. So the best thing to do would be to use align item center plus align content around or between as required. For the purpose of your understanding and reference, I will be providing this file in the description of this video. I will just upload it to one of my servers, and you can just download it from there so that you can better understand the grid system. Here, if you notice that I have linked this file to bootstrap.min.css, which is the main Bootstrap file. Instead of that, you can also link to Bootstrap grid hyphen grid, because this only takes the grid system from the Bootstrap. So you would not be using any other Bootstrap classes for the text or any other thing. It will only use the grid system. Now if you just check it in the browser, I will just show you in the browser by refreshing. So see here, it has lost all the classes but it of the text and other things, but the grid system works fine. However, do remember that the width 100 class, which we have used in this second example, will not work while using the Bootstrap grid CSS, this one here, because this should have divided this row into three rows, but it will not work because this class is not included in the Bootstrap grid CSS file. So if you are using this W100 width in your project, remember that you will have to use the full Bootstrap CSS file. Everything else is working fine in this. So if you want to keep your project sleek, you can just use the Bootstrap grid if you only need the grid system from Bootstrap. Otherwise, it's better to use the complete bootstrap.min.css file. Hope you have understood everything about the grid system, and do like this video. Also subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. I have a Hindi version for this video in my other channel, which is named Magdi Hindi. And apart from that, do press the bell icon so that you get all the updates.